Hello and welcome to the fourth part of our lecture on wind. And in this video, we will talk about how does the wind speed behave in different heights. And there we will learn expressions like the roughness length, and we also will have a look on the logarithmic height formula and the power law according to Hellmann. So when we have a look to this picture with that small wind park on a very plain area, and then we have a look how the wind develops above ground, we see this logarithmic profile of the wind. That means very close to the surface, the wind speed always is zero, and then it develops with increasing height quite fast to bigger wind velocities. And when we are then a few hundred meters high in the sky, then we call that the geostrophic wind. And there, the wind speed is more or less not anymore depending on how the surface is made of. But above the surface, we have a quite turbulent behavior of the wind. And that is decreasing this turbulent behavior the higher we are getting. And then we see at a certain minimum height, then the wind speeds are getting more or less a bit more stable. At least the speed does not increase anymore that much with bigger heights. And that is typically the area where we are trying to get there with the rotors of our wind turbines. When we have a completely different area, for example, here with a hilly or mountainous region with trees, bushes, buildings, then the wind profile develops in lower heights quite chaotic, like we see here in this graph. And only at a certain minimum height, again, we have this development of a logarithmic profile. So that is much more complex. When we now want to describe how the wind speed develops with different heights, we need to use a certain number. That is the roughness length that we call set zero and give in meters. And when we start, let's say we start here at water surfaces, then this roughness length is just 10 to the minus 4 meters. And that means we could explain us this expression of roughness length that up to a certain height of this roughness length, the mean wind velocity due to turbulences is zero. And there we see above water surfaces that is very small. When we then go to bare soil, for example, we are already in the range of 5 times 10 to the minus 3 meters. When we are going to farmland with a few buildings, it is then 3 centimeters. When we go to areas where we have a lot of trees and bushes, it's already 20 centimeters. And when we go to suburb areas where we also can find wind turbines or wind parks, then we are already in a half a meter. And this roughness length set zero, that we need when we want to calculate the different velocities in different heights for a given surrounding surface. And when we see here this wind park here close to Cologne, there we see we have agricultural areas, but also quite a lot of bushes, trees, a forest quite close to it. And then we have a look to the behavior of the wind, how the wind speed develops above ground. And then we see here, for let's assume we have here a roughness length of 20 centimeters. Then in this special moment here, we have a wind speed of 9 meters per second in the hub height of 100 meters. Now we assume, and there we can see, this is quite a high tower that we have in this wind park. When we assume we would have here a different area, for example, grassland, so a very even land with only grass, then we would have, with roughness length of only 1 centimeter, this 9 meters per second already in a height of, let's say, 70 meters. And we could build a much smaller tower for the wind turbine with lower costs. And when we assume even that this wind turbine would stand at a coastline, we would have already at a height of less than 60 meters the same wind speed. And that is also what you can observe when you travel around. At the coasts, you find wind turbines that are quite small with small towers. And the more far away you get from the coasts, more to the mainland, the higher we have the towers. Or when we even construct wind parks in forests, then the towers are getting higher and higher. And when we would like to calculate the development of the wind speeds, for example, we have measurements at a certain height of 10, 20, 30 meters, but interested in a wind speed of a higher height, then we can at least make an approximation by this logarithmic height formula. So when we were interested in a velocity V2 at a height H2, then it behaves like the velocity V1 at a height 1, like the logarithmic, the natural logarithms of H2 divided by the roughness length of this area divided by the natural logarithm of H1 divided by Z0. And by that we at least can have an approximation of the different wind speeds. The good thing is that the same we also can do with our viable parameters, with the scaling factor. So when we have a viable distribution in a certain height but want to construct a wind turbine in a different height, we also could say that that is here the A2 at a given height H2 divided by the viable parameter A1 at a certain height H1. So that behaves the same. And we need to say that also the form parameter changes with different heights. And that is just only an empiric formula that we might express also that we have, for example, the K value in the height 2, that is equivalent to K value in the height 1 plus 0.0081 per meter times the height 2 minus the height 1. But we need to be very careful, it is only an approximation and only valid in a very short difference in heights. There are other approximations and scientific work about that, but for our lecture purposes, that is okay dealing with this one here. Sometimes we are not using in literature or seeing in literature the logarithmic height formula, but we see this Hellmann's law, and Hellmann's law is that we have the V1 in a height H1, that is in relation to V2 at H2, equivalent to the heights itself, H1 divided by H2, and that to alpha, where alpha is equivalent to 0.14 when we have ideal surrounding conditions. And that means that is really only valid, it's only an approximation when the surrounding is absolutely flat in the most part for quite high distances from the turbine itself. And we assume a uniform roughness. Whenever that is not valid, one should not use this Hellmann's law. And with that, I finish here and would like to lead over to the next video, where we will have a look to the European Wind Atlas and look which information and data we can find there for our wind park planning. Thank you very much.